It was great to watch a movie of which you don't know what to expect. Sometimes there'll be movies I add, and I'm like, oh, that looks like a good cast. And then I find out, you know, it's going to be expiring the following month. So I would make sure I watch whatever I can before it expires. Missed out on some good ones, but when I can, I like to try to catch some of them before they're too late. So this movie is Unforgiven, and it is a 1992 movie, directed and produced by Clint Eastwood, also starring Clint Eastwood. This movie so came out 24 years ago, so Clint Eastwood's about 82, 83. So he's still in his 60s in this movie. Maybe 58, 59. It also is written by a gentleman by the name of David Peoples, who also was a writer of the screenplay, or one of the writers of the screenplay for Blade Runner and 12 Monkeys. So we have some great writing here. We also have Morgan Freeman, Gene Hackman, and, I totally blanked on his name. I was just looking at it, and it's such a simple name that I forget it, so I'll look it up real quick. Because it's disrespectful if I don't give the name. It is Richard Harris, who plays a character by the name of English Bob, who's a super sharp shooter, who's got this guy by the name of Beauchamp, who's his assistant, in a sense. And English Bob, the actor Richard Harris, unfortunately, 11 years later, went on to pass away. So, what is interesting is he has some big movies he's been in. Count of Monte Cristo, and a huge role that basically everyone of nerd and geek culture knows, Albus Dumbledore, the first two Harry Potter movies. So that is like, wow. He found that out. I was like, that's awesome. And we know Morgan Freeman from Shawshank Redemption, Bruce Almighty, Unleashed, Red 1, Red 2, countless and countless and countless movies. Clint Eastwood, you know, Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, Dirty Harry's, and as of recently, Gran Torino, which he was also fantastic in. And then Gene Hackman, you know, The Enemy of the State, and there's another one I saw him in. What are you eating? Stop it. So, what happens is a guy by the name of William Money, who plays Clint Eastwood, and he's a retired guy. He's a widower. Would that work? He's a single dad, because unfortunately his wife passed away, and he's taking care of his kids. He used to be this dangerous, like, bad outlaw, in a sense, and along comes this young kid. Not that young, but says, hey, there's a couple dudes. Oh, before I go on, there's a couple of these whores at this saloon with these cowboy guys. The guys get really aggressive and just start slicing at this girl's face, and you're like, what the fuck, dude? This is starting off pretty dark. So we find out later that there's a reward on them for, you know, what they done. So this young kid comes out into William Money's little, not ranch, but just his farmland. It's like out in the middle of nowhere. And says, hey, you know, if you want to get this reward, you know, he tells him about the reward and about these guys, and says, hey, you can get some good amount of money. So William thinks about it, and then he decides to go do it. One of his old friends is... Sorry, man. God, what the fuck? One of his old friends is, Ned Roundtree, who is played by Morgan Freeman. And then we have Little Bill, who is the sheriff of, I'm not exactly sure the town name, but, I think it's like Whiskey Falls or something. So he's not a very fair person. Hey, stop. And, he's very harsh of a person, and so he's kind of a confusing guy, because it's like, okay, is he good, is he bad, we're not really sure. So Will and Ned go with this younger kid to, well, not go with him, they go to meet up with him to go and take out these guys that hurt this whore, this prostitute. So, music is great, the friendship, you know, stuff like that. These whores are really upset at just the town in general, because nobody respects them. They're just, you know, trying to make ends meet, in a sense. And, yeah, so we're introduced to English Bob on a train. He's talking, and then the people on it are like, you know, shut up, you're really annoying, whatever. And we find out that English Bob is actually a more of a lethal person than you think. So Gene Hackman's character, Little Bill, he, you know, is very intolerant of a lot of stuff. So we find out that Will Money, you know, he's trying to practice before he goes out and stuff and to find these guys, and he's a terrible shot. So he, as things go on, a event happens and sparks, like, just everything he knew, and he's just a lethal person again. And Clint Eastwood's performance is great. You know, Clint Eastwood and Morgan Freeman, their companionship and friendship is really cool. You can tell, you know, that they've been friends for a long time. So anyways, that is Unforgiven. It's about a little over 2 hours, so it's not long, but, you know, it's a good length. I mean, it doesn't drag, but, you know, just be prepared to, you know, kind of stick with it for a little while. But it's a great movie. 24 years, man. So it's on Netflix. Expires June 1st. Give it a check out. Yeah.